Have you guys ever seen a weapon in a video game that the enemy is using on you and think to yourself, man, I can't wait to kill them and pick up that weapon and use it myself, only to find out that you can't actually use the gun or said weapon? Well, that's what this video is dedicated to, all of those moments. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to be going over 10 hidden weapons in video games that unfortunately you can't actually use. Now, maybe there's mods or hacking or ways to do it otherwise, but in the original core games, you never get a chance to actually use them. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Kicking off our list today is one of the better superhero movie tie-in games in recent years, and that's saying a lot because most movie tie-in games are pretty crappy, and I'm talking about X-Men Origins, specifically the Frostmourne in X-Men Origins Wolverine. It was a hack and slash featuring fun gameplay, brutal gory combat, and well, there's also a pretty cool Easter egg during the second level of this game. You come across a cave filled with ice, and if you venture inside, you can find the Frostmourne, a legendary sword from the World of Warcraft series. It's going to be super fun using the legendary WoW Blade in the X-Men world, right? Wrong. Despite the sword being presented to you as a new weapon, you can't actually pick it up or use it in combat. While it's an awesome Easter egg, it's a bummer how much of a tease and a troll it is, since you actually can't pick it up and use it. And I'm pretty sure the Frostmourne was during the Lich King raid, wasn't it? That was when I was really big into World of Warcraft. At number 9, we have Rom's Machine Gun in Gears of War. And Gears of War has some pretty awesome guns such as the Lancer, the Nasher Shotgun, and the devastating Hammer of Dawn, which is a literal space laser. But there is one weapon in all of the Gears of War games that you can't use, and it's perhaps the strongest ballistic weapon in the entire series. The gun that Rom uses during the final boss fight of the very first Gears of War game is a variant of the mounted Troika turret that you see throughout the campaign, although his version was modified with an ammo drum and a foregrip, making him able to move around with it instead of just being locked into one spot. Seeing Rom move around with his custom Troika just made all of us want to kill him and take it from him and use it. And all the Gears of War characters are ripped, so why can't we carry around our own portable Troika? Now, I know Rom's bigger than us and stronger, but still. At number 8, we have the Half-Life crowbar in GTA San Andreas. If you've ever played the Half-Life games, you know about Gordon Freeman's signature crowbar. Sure, we all know about the gravity gun, but the crowbar is just as iconic to the Half-Life series as the gravity gun is. But did you guys know that Gordon's crowbar is actually hidden in the GTA San Andreas map? When you play through the San Andreas campaign, there is a mission called Black Project where you break into Area 69 and you steal a jetpack. But if you guys keep an eye on the various rooms you walk past, you will see that one of the rooms has Gordon's signature crowbar sitting on the table, complete with the paint job and signature markings from the Half-Life series. Unfortunately, much like the WoW sword in Wolverine, you can't actually pick up the crowbar or use it for any type of combat. It's a bummer. At number 7, we have the M1911 in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. And this is one of the longest running guns in the Call of Duty franchise, making an appearance in just about every single game in one way or another. And the M1911 was usable in Call of Duty 4's campaign and multiplayer. While it was also available to use in the campaign of Modern Warfare 2, it is not available in multiplayer. And oddly enough, you can still see the pistol in multiplayer. You just can't use it. In the Modern Warfare 2's multiplayer, if you spawn in with a sniper rifle as your primary weapon, your character will have this pistol in their holster. But for some reason, you can't take it out. So, strangely enough, the gun is totally visible on tons of characters in Modern Warfare 2's multiplayer, but it's impossible to actually use it at all. Once again, it's a tease. At number 6, we have Ganondorf's sword in Super Smash Bros. Melee. This one has been confusing Melee fans ever since the game's release back in 2001. If you've ever played any Super Smash Bros. Game, you know how it works. After each match, the game goes to a victory screen where the winning character does a little pose, and each character has 3 different victory poses. Okay, cool. In Melee, one of Ganondorf's victory poses has him swinging around this massive sword and doing his evil laugh. However, You can't actually use the sword in combat, and I don't know. Was Ganondorf originally supposed to have the sword? Did Nintendo have a sword programmed at first, but they cut it out last minute? Why does he have a sword in his victory pose, but he can't actually use it in the game itself? And it's actually made a lot of Melee fans mad and frustrated that they can't utilize this weapon. Yet they can see it, they just can't use it. Cracking into the top five, let's go back to Call of Duty and the most recent Call of Duty, Call of Duty World War II. Let's talk about the revolver. Now, chances are we're going to see this gun in the future due to it supposedly being leaked already, but for now, we'll put it on this list, since at the time of this recording, the revolver is seen in World War II's campaign. It's not actually usable aside from the one segment. At launch, there were only three pistols in Call of Duty World War II, the P-08, the 1911, and the machine pistol. However, during one segment of the campaign, your character all of a sudden whips out a revolver and starts shooting people with it, and this revolver is officially titled the Enfield No. 2. But you can't actually use it anywhere except for this one segment that only lasts about 10 to 20 seconds long, which is a little bit confusing, to be honest. Why can't we use it any more than that? I don't know, why not? And then again, it's not the only hidden unusable pistol in Call of Duty World War II. Let's talk about one more. And that other pistol is, at number 4, the suppressed P-08 in Call of Duty World War II. And this one's a little more accessible in the campaign than the revolver was, but that just makes us want it even more if it's not actually playable in multiplayer. During one mission in the campaign, you go undercover as an enemy officer, and after your cover is blown, you bring out your trusty P-08 pistol with the suppressor. The only issue that I and many other players have with the segment is the fact that it's the only time you can ever use suppressor on pistols, which is a true bummer. There's a few brief segments during the campaign where suppressed pistols are available to you, but in multiplayer, it's not. How come the Airborne Division can't use suppressors on their pistols, yet they can put suppressors on their SMGs? I don't get it. At number 3, we have the iconic energy sword on Halo Combat Evolved. What? What, Jimmy? The energy sword? It's true! The energy sword is one of the most iconic weapons in Halo history and has appeared in every single game, but it wasn't actually usable in the original. In Combat Evolved, you commonly came across elites wielding the dreaded energy sword, but after killing them, you couldn't pick up the weapon at all. It wasn't until we got Halo 2 that you could actually use the energy sword yourself, and up until that point, it was just one big tease from Bungie, but at least it was a tease that they figured out everybody wanted, and they capitalized on it and put it in all of the games to come. I think it's been in most every Halo game ever since, but in the original one, those dreaded elites and their energy sword that you did not want to see, you couldn't pick it up and use it. At number 2, we have Varius in Duke Nukem 3D, and this is a pretty awesome Easter egg, I'll admit. Back when Duke Nukem was actually good, the games used to poke fun at pop culture all the time. Action movies, other FPS games, they poked fun at everything. And in Duke Nukem 3D, they took it so far and featured hidden areas where you could find dead heroes from other franchises. In one area, you could find the corpse of Luke Skywalker. In a different area, you could find a dead Indiana Jones. And in another area, you could find the iconic Doom guy chopped in half and laying in a bloody heap. Unfortunately, you can't take any of the weapons from these bodies. How cool would it be if you could grab Doomguy's BFG, or even Luke's lightsaber, or even Indy's signature whip, and play with it in Duke Nukem? Although I can't give him too much heat for it, because, I mean, I love Easter eggs, and this was really cool. And at number 1 today, we go back to Warcraft. Well, Warcraft 3. We're talking about the Hydralisk. As a big fan of the older Blizzard games like StarCraft and Warcraft, it's pretty much impossible for me not to put this at number 1, because Blizzard is known for filling their games with Easter eggs, and this is perhaps my favorite one that I've ever seen. In Warcraft 3, while traversing certain areas, you can actually stumble upon a Hydralisk, which, if you don't know, it's an alien creature from the StarCraft games. Once you come across it, you will have to kill it or it will attack your troops. So, why is it on this list, you may ask? Well, because you actually can't add the Hydralisk to your forces, and I know that it's technically a thing and not a weapon, but come on, give me this one. This is such a cool Easter egg, and if you could add him to your team, that would be really, really cool. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 hidden weapons that you can see, you can unlock. Unfortunately, you can't use them. Let me know if there's any others that we didn't think about that didn't make the list. There's a playlist below if you guys want to check out all the other gaming top 10s. And make sure you guys turn on your notifications. Drop a like, subscribe on your way out if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you tomorrow night for a brand new one.